Hi everyone, it's Debbie from Dare to Date, second chance at this. Look, I want to talk to you tonight about something a little bit different, and I want to talk about how dating and having your own business are pretty similar and how they take some of the same skills. So the first thing I want to talk about is when you start a business, you need commitment, dedication, and focus on what you want to achieve. If you're going to achieve anything, and when something doesn't work, you kind of look at going, okay, that's working, this isn't working, I need to change something. So the same applies when it comes to dating. You know, you have to look at what is working and what isn't working. And if something's not working, you adjust it and change it. Now, I don't know if anyone is watching Single Wives on Channel 7. So far, I love that show. I love Matt Hussey and the advice that he offers. And it's really easy when you sit back and you're watching what someone's doing right or what's doing wrong. I had a conversation with my mum today and she goes, yeah, it was pretty easy to see what they were doing wrong. And to be honest, it was. And I know that when people come speed dating and, you know, they tell me their experiences, from my perspective, it can be really easy also to see what people are doing right and doing wrong. So in the episode last night, they've got four stunning women who've not had any luck in love. Like they've had, some of them had one failed marriage, some have had two, one had their husband die. So, you know, looks alone are not going to get you the relationship. Sometimes looking at, you know, what you do, how you're doing it, what you choose is really important. And so when they were looking at what the girls were doing dating, they looked at one particular girl and she didn't want to waste time with the wrong person, okay? So she had this list of questions that she would ask them in the date. And a man actually said to her, well, that is not allowing you to build connection. So when you have a conversation with someone, you need to, you know, not fire questions one after the other. You have to have this conversation where it is, you ask them something, they ask you something back. And to be honest, none of that's important in, you know, the first 5 minutes of meeting people, which is what I tell people when they come speed dating all the time. Just find if you like someone. So when she changed what she was doing, her whole outcome and how she got along with the people changed entirely. So it's really important to look at what we're doing and the results that we're getting, and it changes everything. So the next thing where I'm saying, you know, it's like a business. With my business, whether it works or not, or anyone's business, it's actually our responsibility. No one's going to do it for us. No one's going to solve the problems. The same comes when it comes to dating. You've got to look at what you're doing, what's working, what's not, and take responsibility for it. Total responsibility, and not put that outside of yourself. And too many people, when dating's not working for them, will blame an app or blame coming to an event that didn't work. Whereas, you know, kind of look at what you're doing and the vibes that you're putting out there. The next thing is knowing what you want to achieve. So in a business, you have to know what you're going to achieve. You have to have some sort of a business plan to make it work. Otherwise, you don't get the results you want. Same when it comes to a relationship. And I say this thing all the time, that it can be really easy to leave things up to chemistry, okay? And the problem with chemistry, and everyone's looking for this lightning bolt from heaven, whereas chemistry shuts down the left frontal cortex. I'm saying this all the time. And especially when it comes to the judgment with the person that you've got chemistry with. So if you have a plan, like a business plan, where you know what's important to you, you won't end up falling for a person that doesn't work. And what I'm saying, I'm not talking about superficial traits like how tall they are, but values. So for example, if a woman wanted children and she meets a guy and she's got massive chemistry, but he doesn't want to have kids, I can tell you that the long-term success of what they're going to do is just not going to work, okay? It's that simple. Same if you know, one person is really wants to travel the world and the other person doesn't. You kind of got different values and different goals for life. So it ends up breaking a relationship apart. So that's why in a business you need a plan, and you need that in a relationship. Don't leave the most important area of your life to chance. Now, 50% of first marriages fail and 37% of second marriages fail. And look, one of the biggest reasons I think they do is because people leave it too much to chemistry, which is insane. Now, the next... Oh, sorry, I'm not very loud. Shall I talk louder and move the camera in closer? Ugh. Anyway, the next thing that is really important is personal branding and marketing to a business. If people don't know you exist, you're not going to get any business. The same applies if you're single. Also, you know, how your personal brand is everything, how you come across. And as a business, you have to solve people's problems. You have to answer and do what they need you to be doing. Otherwise, it's not going to work and it's not going to be successful. The same applies to single people. Your personal branding and your marketing is everything. Don't lead with your insecurities, your past failures, and what hasn't worked for you in the past. Come with the best version of yourself to get the best outcome. Now, the next thing that I want to say is, in business, rejection is part of what you do. You know, like, people won't choose not to use your services. You won't be able to answer everyone's problems. And the same applies, you know, like, if in a business you got so hung up on whether you were successful or not, and the fear of failure, you'd never achieve anything. The same comes when you're single. So I know when I first started my business and I used to send out my weekly email and people would unsubscribe. To start with, I used to take it personally and think, oh, what have I done wrong? What could I do better? Why are they unsubscribing? And you know, half the time they'd unsubscribe because they met someone at my event, but they didn't tell me that. So taking it personally doesn't help me improve my services. So if people are unsubscribing, I'm either being successful or I'm not meeting what they want me to do as business. I'm not solving their problems or I'm not the type of service that they're looking for. The same comes when you're rejected as a single person. You know, it's really important to look at what you're doing and not take that rejection personally. I mean, to be honest, not everyone's cup of tea. Like, you could be a blonde and the person likes a brunette. A million different reasons why people don't want to go out with other people. I've had people tell me that, well, she reminded me of my ex-sister-in-law. Lovely person, but I just couldn't go there. You know, none of that is personal. So take the rejection out of the whole dating thing and it will make it a lot easier. Whereas I think people kind of get hung up on that rejection thing. The final thing that I want to say is network. So for a business to be successful, again, like I said, people need to know we exist. And networking is one way you do that. So you get out and you meet as many people as possible. You tell people exactly what you're doing. And, you know, some people when they go networking don't want to talk to people unless they're going to get business from them, which is not the way to go because they could refer me to someone else who refers me to someone else. Well, the same applies when you're single, okay? You know, you might meet someone and they'll introduce you to their friends. So I know people get hung up if they come to a singles party and go, well, what if I don't want to date that person? Well, that person could introduce you to someone else or you could become friends. And I say this all the time too. Some of the best relationships that I know, they say they would have said no in a 5-minute speed date. They would have said no to online dating. Sometimes you need to get to know someone first and slowly and being friends without that pressure and without that expectation. So like in a business, they say you need 6 points of contact to get a sale from someone. Well, you know, the same applies sometimes when we're single. Get out and meet people. Get some referrals. Get your friends to introduce you to people who might be good for you. Like, get out. Do networking. Do singles events. Do speed dating. Do meetup groups. Get out of the house. I mean, we've got Uber Eats. We don't have Uber Love yet. So at this stage, you still need to get out of your house to go meet someone. So get out as much as you can. Meet as many people because it is a numbers game. If you think in life of how many people you cross paths with that you may be attracted to, it's not as many as you think. So, you know, don't give up. The person you're looking for is also looking for you. And, you know, that's the end of the tips that I want to share with you. But I do want to say, for anyone that's 30 to 45, not this weekend, but next weekend, we've got an amazing singles weekend away. And the whole aim is not to look at, to go away and have a fun weekend We're going to go to a winery. We've got, it's really amazing value. I think the only thing you have to buy is lunch and your drinks. And it's $320 and you get your own room. And it's only 90 minutes from Perth. So it's a great way to go meet some new friends, to go see the southwest and go have some fun. And on that note, it's been nice talking to you all. Thanks all for watching and see you next time. Bye.